We're here to talk about an officer-involved shooting incident that occurred yesterday. Cincinnati police officers received a radio call to 3407 Montgomery Road in response to a man with a gun. We did learn as a part of this investigation that the same suspect with a gun was seen earlier in the day armed with a gun and acting in a strange manner. We have no indication that a radio call was made. That suspect, who we're describing as Mr. Ronnie Pittman, who is a male black, 54 years, and he has a date of birth of 12/29/57. His criminal history, and he has a prior criminal history of 12 misdemeanor arrests with 9 convictions, 15 felony arrests with 5 convictions, 53 traffic citations with 31 convictions, 5 felony weapon charges, and 4 felony crimes of violence. Just as a point, do we have anyone operating the...
Yes.
What's depicted is the map where the call of service came out, 3407 Montgomery Road. That call came out at 5:30 yesterday, and again the call came out, a man with a gun making a statement, "I am going to kill someone, I want to die, I want to shoot this place up." The officers that responded was the sergeant who described again as Sergeant Daryl Grant. Sergeant Daryl Grant was hired with the Cincinnati Police Department in February 7th of 1993, and he was promoted to sergeant on 11/23/2005. Along with Sergeant Grant responding to the call for service were 4 additional officers, all assigned to District 2. Once the officers responded, can we go to the next page? This is an aerial view of the location. And if you look here, I'll just point, this depicts the location of where the suspect lived. He lived in a lower residence. This large building here is depicted as a tire center or tire store. Once the officers responded to the call for service, and there was indication that it was a man with a gun, the officers were directed to the rear of the location. And once they went to the rear of the locations, the officer saw a doorway that was ajar and saw the suspect, Mr. Pittman, at which time, as the officers closed in on location, they saw the suspect reach in his rear and remove a gun. And as he removed the gun, he began to take the slide on the gun and move it in a rearward direction, suggesting operating a semi-automatic handgun. At that point, the sergeant deployed his weapon and advised the suspect several times to drop the weapon. Refusing to do so, the sergeant fired one shot, striking the suspect. And after the shot was fired, the suspect continued to advance on the sergeant. The sergeant once again directed the suspect to drop the weapon. The sergeant then fired a second shot. Sergeant believed the shot may have taken effect, was not certain. The sergeant or the suspect then retreated back into his residence and shut the door. At that point, the officers backed away from the location. Additional resources were notified. We also had information that there was a possibility of a female acquaintance inside of a location. It was determined later that the female acquaintance was transported a day earlier to a local hospital for treatment of a medical condition. Our SWAT resources were notified. We set up on the location. It was at this time that we went through a methodical deployment. We checked the location. We attempted to call the suspect out. There was no response. And after talking to witnesses and rendering the location as a safe location, we finally made entry, at which time we discovered the suspect inside and had suffered from a gunshot wound. We did have a SWAT medical doctor as part of the SWAT team. The SWAT doctor approached the suspect, and he was pronounced dead. At that point, we started our follow-up investigation. One point was mentioned last night. There was a discharge of a weapon at the location by one of our SWAT supervisors, and that matter is still under investigation. At this point, this is a closer view of the location. As you can see, the location is a two-story building. One of the challenges that we had trying to get inside, that there were many secure doors that we had to go into it, prior to getting to the suspect. Next one, please. This is a close-up view. This is the location where the suspect resided, a stairway leading down into where he lived. This is the inside of his residence. I'll just take a note that this is the blood trail. After the shooting incident and the fact that the suspect closed the door, he backed away. And this is the weapon that was possessed by the suspect at the time of the officer-involved shooting. We determined that weapon was a BB gun. It had an active slide to it, and the officers believed at the time of the shooting incident that he, in fact, did have a gun and that their lives were in danger. This is another view of the gun, and this is the suspect, Ronnie Pittman, 54 years of age, male, black. This is the information again on Sergeant Grant. And again, it says District 4. He's actually assigned to District 2. Any more? At this point, I'll open it up for any questions.
Well, as Chief, as the officer encountered Mr. Pittman, you say he fired and hit him with a bullet. Where in the body was he hit?
At this point, it appears now that the suspect was struck twice, once in his neck and once in his upper torso. At the time, or immediately following the shooting incident, the sergeant was unaware whether or not the rounds he fired took effect. He was not certain at that point.
So he was shot in the neck first?
We don't know if that was the first shot or the second shot. We just know that two shots were fired, and it appears that both shots struck the suspect.
And Pittman kept coming towards the officer after the first shot?
After the first shot, the suspect did advance as the sergeant continued to give, you know, demands of drop the weapon, drop the weapon. That statement was supported by an independent witness who resided in the building.
What do you conclude as a result of the officer's actions and then now knowing that it was a 10-inch BB gun?
Well, you know, our investigation is still certainly ongoing, and based on the officer's statements, the statement of the independent witness, certainly the officer feared for his life, certainly the safety of his partners, and preliminarily it appears that the shots fired, the force used was appropriate.
Any other questions?
Are you able to tell us anything more about Mr. Pittman? You ran down a long list of arrests. Is there anything more that you can share with us? It looks like he turned 54 yesterday.
Yes, it was his birthday. Again, what we do know, and certainly there's a toxicology evaluation will be conducted. We're not saying that he was under the influence of alcohol. However, depicted inside our location was an open bottle of alcohol. Certainly, witnesses reported that he was acting in a strange manner, possibly consistent with intoxication. Witnesses also suggested that it was during this time of the month, usually during the first of the month, that he's done this before. And there have been instances where he has been in possession of a gun. And again, earlier yesterday, he was seen with a gun, and it doesn't appear that anyone called at that time.
Given his long arrest record, was Sergeant Grant or any of the other officers familiar with him, who they were dealing with? Did they know him?
I'm not certain of that yet.
Between the time that the sergeant and the other officers from District 2 responded and the SWAT team got there, how long was it between the time the SWAT team was able to get in
call came out at 5:30. SWAT actually made entry into the suspect's location at roughly 8:30. During that time, certainly I touched on it briefly, the fact that we wanted to secure the location. We're talking about an armed suspect inside of an apartment building. One of the things we're all concerned for is the safety of the people that live there, so we had to resolve that issue. There was another issue in terms of deploying a robot inside, because we're talking about an armed suspect. That takes time. The fact that we made numerous attempts to call the suspect out via a PA system unsuccessfully, and so it took some time. If you need more information in terms of what SWAT's role was between the time SWAT actually arrived and the time we made entry, Assistant Chief Whalen, who oversaw that part of the operation, can fill you in.
How many people live in that apartment?
I'm not certain.
We know there was a place upstairs, and then the deceased who lived downstairs, there were some other apartments there.
What about Sergeant Grant? Does he have any sort of history? Any sort of shooting involved with before?
No, not at all.
Can you tell us again about who made the call and
Well, you mean in terms of the initial call for service?
Yes.
The resident made the initial call for service. He witnessed and saw the suspect acting in a bizarre manner. He saw the fact that the suspect was armed with a gun, and that certainly raised his concern in safety and the safety of the residents, and that's when the call was made. And again, I'm unsure why a call was made earlier.
Now, who was the one who made this statement?
One of the witnesses overheard him making that statement in the rear of the location prior to our arrival.
Okay, can you go over exactly what he heard?
Basically, what he heard was, I'm going to kill someone or kill someone, somebody. I want to die. I'm going to shoot this place up. I'm adding a word in. He said something actually a little different. But that kind of comment. Any other questions?
The most recent shooting from police was the Fountain Square shooting.
Yes, it was. Okay, thank you very much.